In the last lesson, we wrote this code to start the environment cart pull v1. And we found that the env.reset function starts the simulation and it also returns something. This return value is actually the state of the environment in the initial state of the simulation. We know that we can see the environment in its initial state by using the env.render function. And the initial state looks somewhat like this. And this NumPy array is just an alternative, simpler description of this initial state. And it is called the observation. So we shall write obs equal to env.reset, meaning that we will store the return value of env.reset in a variable called obs, which stands for observation. We can also print that out. Sorry, needs to be obs. The most important thing to understand about the observation is its general nature. So is it continuous or discrete? Is it a scalar, vector, or a tensor? What is the range of the values of each element in the observation? What is the Python data type of each element in the observation? And so on. The attribute observation space of the env object gives us the answers to all these questions. You see, the env.observation space returns an output like this. Now, to understand the meaning of this output, we will need to understand some of the gym data types, like box, for instance, which you see here. Box is a gym data type which describes NumPy arrays with elements taking values continuously in a range. So if you see box in the output, then you know that the observation is continuous. The third element of the output is the shape of the NumPy array, which you see here. So here the third element is 4, which means that the underlying NumPy array is a vector with 4 dimensions, which also matches what we saw earlier. The lower range and the upper range of the elements in the NumPy array is given by the first and the second element. The first element is the lower range and the second element is the upper range. So this means, for example, that the first element can take values between minus 4.8 to plus 4.8. The second element can take values between minus infinity to plus infinity and so on. Finally, the fourth element is the NumPy data type. And in this case, it is a float 32. That gives us the general overview of the nature of the observation in this environment. The next step is to understand the meanings of the elements in the observation, so the meanings of these numbers. And for that, we need to find the documentation for the environment. And there are 4 possible places where you can find the documentation for the environment. The first place to look would be the environment page in Gym's website. This is the environment page for cart pull v1, but unfortunately, it does not contain much information about the elements of the observation. So we go to the next source, which is the wiki in Gym's GitHub repository. So this is the GitHub repository and this is the wiki section of the cart pull environment. And if we go down here, we see that there is a table explaining the meanings of the elements in the observation. The first element corresponds to the cart position. Second element corresponds to the cart velocity. The third element corresponds to the pole angle, and the fourth element corresponds to the pole velocity at the tip. And in general, positive values typically mean the right side, and the negative values means the left side. So for example, if the velocity, which is the second element, the cart velocity is negative, it means that the cart is moving towards the left. If you don't find the information in the wiki entry, then the next place to look would be the source code of the environment. And you can find that by going to Gym's GitHub and then going to the folder ends, and then you will find the environment somewhere inside that folder. Here is the source code for the cart pole environment, and we see that in the docstring there is a lot of information about the elements of the observation. If all of these three fail, then you look into the fourth source, for which you also go to the environment page in Gym's website, and then you check if it references some research paper, which it does over here. And if it does, then you try to find that research paper and see if you can find the meanings of the elements in that research paper. So to summarize, we learned that the observation in the cart pole environment looks like this, and this basically describes the circles, the states in the environment, which we have been drawing in the diagrams.